Hello and welcome to Tutorials Point. In this session, we'll be learning about JavaScript functions. A function is a block of code written to perform specific operation. It is written to perform a specific task. In JavaScript, to declare a function, we use the keyword function followed by name of the function, and inside curly brackets, we declare the body of a function, that is the task which we have to perform. To call a function, we use function name followed by brackets and followed by semicolon. We can also pass arguments to a function. Maybe we can pass one argument, sometimes we can pass two arguments as per the requirements. Like here, we are passing two arguments to the sum function, a and b. So while calling the function, we need to pass two values also. Like here, we are passing 2 and 3 as values. So this 2 and 3 goes into a and b, and it is utilized inside the function body. Self-invoking function. Self-invoking function, also known as instantly invoked function, is a kind of function which invokes itself. That is, we don't need to call this function, it calls itself. Here, this function which returns 2 into 4, it calls itself at the end of function. These brackets and semicolon specifies that it is a self-invoking function. Scope. So there are two kinds of scope basically. One is local scope and another is global scope. So if a variable is declared inside a function, it can be accessed only inside that function. So it has the scope of local. Consider if a variable is declared outside a function. So it has global scope. It can be accessed inside a function, outside a function, everywhere in the program. Let's see all these things practically.
In this web page, we have written a heading JavaScript functions using H1 tag. In our script tag, we have declared a function named sum, which returns the value of 2 plus 3. I'm calling this function from here, and I'm storing the value returned by this function in variable I. I'm using console.log to log the value of I in console, that is the value returned by sum function. Another function we have declared is multiply. It is taking two arguments, a and b. We are passing these arguments when we are calling the function multiply as 4 and 5. So 4 goes into a and 5 goes into b, and we get a into b as the return value, which is stored in m variable. We are using console.log to log this variable again. Third thing is, we have declared a self-invoke function here, which is not called by anywhere, but it prints self-invoke function. Let's see how all this works. So we can see I is returned as 5, which was sum of 2 and 3. So this is our output. Next is m. M is returned as a into b. So a had value 4 and b had value 5. So we got 20 as our output. So that's also correct. Next thing we see is self-invoke function printed out here, which we have written inside this. So this is how our self-invoke function works. Next thing is, let's see how scope works. I've declared a variable here, which is named scopy, and I've given it a value of 5. I've declared a function scopy test, which contains another variable scopy2, which contains value of 3. I'm returning scopy into scopy2 here. I'm calling this function from here and storing the value in variable j. I'm using console.log to log the value of j. Let's see the output of this. So scopy test returns 15. That is this thing. It returns me 5 into 3, that is the value of scopy into the value of scopy 2. Next thing is, I've declared a new variable scopy 3 here, and I'm storing scopy 2's value into scopy 3 variable. Scopy 2, which is a local variable to scopy test function, whereas scopy was a global variable which we use inside scopy test function. Now we are trying to use this local variable here outside the function. Let's see what we get as a result. We get an error that scopy2 is not defined. That's because scopy2 has its scope limited to this scopy test function. It has a local scope, so we cannot pass the value of scopy2 inside scopy3 outside the scopy test function. If I try to pass the value of scopy here, then I will get the output as 5. So that's because scopy has a global scope. So that was all about functions. Thank you.